Hello everyone, in this video I'll be explaining about the details of photosynthesis. If you're watching this, I suggest that you watch the first video, which is photosynthesis overview that I've posted earlier. This is a picture just to remind you of what I've said earlier. So we have in photosynthesis we have two main steps, the light reaction and the Calvin cycle reaction. This might also be called light dependent reaction, and this might be called light independent reaction. The purpose of these two is that in the light reaction, solar energy is used plus H2O to give out oxygen as a waste product, and these two important molecules, NADPH, ATP, for the Calvin cycle to be used to build glucose molecule out of CO2 from the atmosphere. This returns ADP and ADP plus to be recharged here, and the whole cycle repeats. The light reaction occurs in the membrane of the thylakoid, and the Calvin cycle occurs in the stroma. If we go to the details of each cycle, or each step. In the light reaction, so we said it happens in the membrane of the thylakoid. So if I'm going to draw, this is the membrane of the thylakoid. This would be the outside, which is the stroma, and this would be the inside of the thylakoid. Now, in the membrane of the thylakoid, you will have complex molecules called photosystem, PS. You have two types of photosystem. You have photosystem 2 and photosystem 1. These photosystems will be everywhere in the thylakoid membrane. Now I'm just showing a part where two photosystems are present. The difference between them is that they absorb different wavelengths of light. What's special about the photosystems, they are made up of chlorophyll molecules, a lot of chlorophyll molecules, which are the molecules that are able to absorb sunlight. And once sunlight, strikes each photosystem, both photosystems, what happens is that the photosystem loses electrons. So the sunlight will start bouncing off the chloroplasts, the chlorophyll, until it excites an electron which leaves the photosystem. Now let's start with photosystem 2. Photosystem 2 is struck by sunlight, loses an electron. This leaves photosystem 2 lacking one electron, or lacking electrons. The photosystem 2 have to replace these electrons, and the way it replaces them is by using H2O. H2O, or water, will be broken down with the help of the sunlight by a process called photolysis or photolysis. In photolysis, H2O, excuse the handwriting, will be broken down into oxygen, which will be released into the atmosphere, and H plus ions. Of course, to balance this reaction, we would have 2H2O and 4H plus here. Now, this breaking down of H2O will give us the electrons that photosystem 2 have lost, and this way we're fine with photosystem 2. It lost electrons, it gained the electrons back. Now, these electrons that left photosystem 2 will go to a series of proteins or molecules that form what we call the ETC, or electron transport chain. The names and the places and the number of these molecules are not required for you to know in this course. What happens exactly that these electrons will start passing from one molecule to the other, and until it reaches photosystem 1. Now, this passage or this journey of the electrons through these, through the ETC, will cause or will give the enough energy for these molecules to pump H plus ions, more H plus ions, from outside the thylakoid to the inside of the thylakoid. So H pluses will be pumped from the outside to the inside, and we will have a lot of H plus inside the thylakoid. We'll get to what's the purpose of these later. Now let's see photosystem 1. Just as photosystem 2, light hits it and it loses an electron. Now the difference between PS2 and PS1 is that photosystem 2 gains the electrons back from the breaking down of water. Photosystem 1 gains the electron back from the electron coming from the ETC, which in the first place left the photosystem 2. So now we're fine also with photosystem 1. It lost electrons and it gained these electrons back. This electron that it lost will be directly accepted by the electron carrier, which we mentioned before, NADP+, which when it carries this electron becomes NADPH. This is the first important molecule that we formed from the light reaction, and this will go to the Calvin cycle to be used. Now we still have to make ATP. For this to occur, we have this molecule. This complex molecule called ATP synthase. Since it ends with A's, then this is an enzyme. ATP synthase is the enzyme that's able to make ATP out of ADP, or kind of recharge ADP into ATP. Now, if you remember in the ETC, the journey of the electron pumped H plus is here. Now we have high concentration of H plus in the inside the thylakoid than outside. This concentration gradient will drive the H plus to go back there. Now they cannot pass through anywhere because it's a semi-permeable membrane. The only place they can pass through is through the ATP synthase. Now the passage of H plus, of course, this is driven by the concentration gradient. The passage of the H plus through the ATP synthase will cause the ATP synthase to rotate. This is just like a water mill. The water passes, gives the mill energy to do some work. Now this rotation of the ATP synthase will give it energy to use ADP, transform it into ATP. And thus we've just made our second important molecule, ATP, and which will also go both NADPH and ATP to the Calvin cycle. This is the process of light reaction. We've used sunlight, we've used H2O, we've produced oxygen, and we've produced NADPH ATP out of NADP plus ADP. If we go to the Calvin cycle, the Calvin cycle, as we said, is the process that starts with CO2 and ends up with glucose. It has three steps. The first step is called carbon fixation, where the CO2 enters from the atmosphere to the cells, to the chloroplast, to the stroma of the chloroplast, and it's fixed by a molecule called RuBP. RuBP is a 5-carbon molecule, so it's a molecule containing 5 carbons. CO2 is a molecule containing only 1 carbon. The binding of these happens with the help of an enzyme called Rebisco. Now, this binding will create a 6-carbon molecule. Of course, 5 plus 1, that's 6. This 6-carbon molecule is very unstable, so it directly breaks down into 2 molecules, each one having 3 carbon molecule. These 3 carbon molecules are called 3PG. These have 3 carbons each. So the molecule of 3PG would be having 3 carbons. Now this molecule of 3PG is not useful for us or for the plant to make glucose. That's why it needs to be changed in the second step called carbon reduction. It needs to be changed into a different form called G3P. It still has 3 carbons. It's just the structure is changed. And we still have 2 of it, of course, because we started with 2. This step will be needing energy from ATP and NADPH. dpH. Where do these come from? You should know that these come from the light reaction. So the ATP will be used to give back ADP, and then ADPH will be used to give out an ADP plus, which will go back to the light reaction to be recharged. Okay, now we'll have CO2 coming in a lot, and which will allow us to form a lot of molecules of G3P. These molecules, some of them will be used to form glucose, and the rest of them, or some of them, will go back to regenerate RUBP in the third step called RUBP regeneration. Why do we need to regenerate that? Because if we run out of RUBP, there's nothing to fix CO2 anymore. And also this step uses ATP. When I show an arrow like this, it means ATP is used, the energy is transferred here, and ADP is produced, which will go to the light reaction to be recharged. Now, let's speak more clearly about the numbers. We said in photosynthesis we need 6 CO2 to make 1 glucose. So we need this cycle to run 6 times to end up with a glucose molecule. If 6 CO2 comes in, then they should bind to 6 molecules of RUBP. Each one will bind to one, which will give us 6 molecules of a 6 carbon molecule. This will break down. Each 6 carbon molecule will break down into 2 3PG. So 6 carbon molecules will break down into 12 3PG. Each of the 12 3PG will be changed into G3P, which gives us 12 G3P. Now, if you think how many G3P we need to make one glucose, well, glucose contains 6 carbons, and G3P contains 3 carbons, so we would need 2 of the G3P to make one glucose. This leaves us with 10 G3P, which will all go to regenerate the 6 RUBP. If you think of the numbers of carbons, 10 with each 3 carbons, that's 30 carbon. To make 6, each has 5 carbons, that's also 30 carbons. So nothing is created, nothing is destroyed. The 6 carbon that we got from here ended up in the glucose, and the rest are being regenerated throughout the cycle. This is the Calvin cycle. It used the energy from the light reaction, and whatever it threw back as empty batteries, ADP and ADP plus, will go back to the light reaction to be recharged. We've used CO2 and we've made glucose, which is the purpose of photosynthesis. This happened in the stroma, of course. This is the Calvin cycle and the light reaction, and these are the details steps. I hope the drawing was helpful, not too messy, and thank you.